Enable subtitle CC. Hello everyone, in this video we will learn how to make an aimbot for Unity games. Before we start the tutorial, I will show what an aimbot is and why it is used. As you can see, when aimbot is enabled, our aim automatically locks onto the enemy's head. This video only shows how to lock the aim. For the full advanced source, message me on Telegram at AADIL OP. It includes line of sight checks so it won't aim at enemies behind objects, head only aim, filter options, like aiming only when holding a weapon or when the enemy is within a set distance, fully commented code explaining every line. Let's start. Open the game. Aimbot is not very hard, we just need to control the aim with code and move it to any point we want. In the game, I added an offset tester. First, I will find the offsets that control aim movement. Some games use camera rotation for aiming, so first we will test if Dude Theft Wars uses it too. First, let's check the original values of the main camera rotation. If they change when we move the aim, we'll test set rotation. You can get the camera rotation by first getting the camera instance, then its transform using the class component, and finally using the transforms get rotation method. The values change when we move the aim, so now let's test set rotation. Using set rotation is similar to get rotation. In the offset tester, go to the set void or field section instead of display values, and use the set rotation offset instead of get rotation. Even after using set rotation, our aim didn't change. This means we can't use camera rotation in this game. In some games, changing the local player's forward values moves the aim, so you can test that too. In the player controller class, there is a look field, so let's test that too. Enter the player controller update offset. Link to class look using the look field. Then display the pitch and yaw fields from the look class. I used vector 2 so it can show both pitch and yaw at the same time. Anyway, the pitch and yaw values change when I move the aim, so now let's set them with our own values. Since you can't hook the same offset twice, we used the update offset in display values. Now, in set field or void, we use fixed update. If the class has only one update, go to VIP and Tools, unhook the update offset, and then use it in set field or void. As you can see, when I set the pitch to a fixed 3, the aim didn't move vertically. Setting the yaw fixed the horizontal aim too, which shows this is the correct offset for creating our custom aim. We can now move the aim using offsets, but we want it to point toward the enemy. Let's write the code for that. Open the project in the AIDE app. I'm using LGL mod menu for 0.0. I'm making the aimbot menu for ARM 64, so I will remove ARM 7 from application.mk. I'm also removing the unused code and examples so main.cpp looks clean. Create the aimbot toggle with feature number 10. Create a bool variable for the aimbot as well. We will change the aimbot value through the toggle, so add it inside case 10. I already made a CPP file with the full code, so instead of writing everything again, I'll just copy it and explain it. This is the hook for our player controller fixed update method. Inside the hook, if the aimbot variable is true, it calls the call player update method and passes the player instance. Inside the function, we first get the player transform so we can read the player position, then we store it in the global variable local player position, so other functions can use it too. For enemy data, we need to create a struct for it. So now, let's add the required structs and functions. like Vector 2, Vector 3, and their helper functions. You may also need a quaternion struct in some games, so you can add that as well, and this is our enemy data struct. We will also need to convert radians to degrees later, so create a global rad2deg variable and store the value of 180 divided by pi. Also create an enemy data variable. Now add the getTransform and getTransformPositionCall methods. If you don't know what they do or how they work, watch my previous tutorial videos. In short, getTransform gives access to the Transform class, and the Transform class has the getPosition method, which gives the position of objects like the player, enemies, and more. Anyway, now let's add the enemy update hook. The hook condition is similar to the player hook. It just calls the enemy update function and passes the instance when aimbot is enabled. Let's add the call enemy update function, and then I'll explain the code inside it. First, let's go to the manui class. Since the enemy update comes from this class, we can access all its fields and methods. We only want to aim at living players, so we'll use the health and is alive fields to check if the enemy is alive. If the enemy is dead, skip it. Otherwise, get the transform instance and then the enemy's position. Then we calculate the distance between the enemy and our player using the vector 3 helper function. Then get the direction by subtracting the enemy's position from our player's position. It's also better to normalize the direction to avoid invalid pitch and yaw values. Now, if the enemy's distance is less than the stored distance, we save that enemy's data. Here's how it works. Let's say there are 5 enemies, the enemy update runs 5 times per frame, giving 5 different enemy instances. By default, the stored distance is maximum, so the first enemy's distance is always less and gets stored. If the second enemy is closer than the first, its data replaces the first, otherwise, the first stays. This way, each frame stores the data of the closest enemy. Now that we store the closest enemy's data each frame, let's see how to use it. In the player update, we check each frame if an enemy is available. If it is, we call the move aim to enemy function and then reset the enemy data. This way, enemy data is reset every frame. Now let's add the move aim to enemy function, and then I'll explain the code inside. First, we store the enemy direction in a new variable, then we get instance of the look class. If you check the player controller class, there is a look field that gives us access to the look class. In the offset tester, we already tested that we need to change pitch and yaw. To get pitch and yaw that point toward the enemy, we use the AIDE to F function, which gives the angle in radians, then we multiply it by rad2deg to convert it to degrees. Now we just need to set the look class pitch and yaw values to our calculated pitch and yaw, and if you are wondering how I got the formula to calculate pitch and yaw, I used ChatGPT. You can also use AI to help you with modding. Now we just need to add the offsets for the calling and hooking methods. I'm not going to explain the same things in every tutorial, so if you don't understand this part, please watch the previous tutorial videos. This code works for games that use pitch and yaw. If a game uses rotation instead, you need a different method. Let me show you how it works for a game that uses rotation. When I was testing Dead Target, rotation worked for it. Let me show you how I tested it. Its player class is also player controller, and like always, we hook the update offset. There is a quaternion rotation field in the player class, so let's test it and see if it can move the aim. First, we are testing the target rot field. The values didn't change when I moved the aim, so this is the wrong field. Let's try the next field. This time, the values change when I move the aim, so this might be the correct field. Now let's set it and see if it actually works. But first, we need to unhook the update offset, since we can't hook it multiple times. Now, just enter the update offset in field, Keep in mind, the rotation values range from minus 1 to 1. It worked! My aim doesn't move at all because the rotation values are fixed at 1, 0, 1, 0. Now let me show how to get the rotation values that point toward the enemy. Since the game uses a rotation field instead of pitch and yaw, we modify the rotation field. And it's a quaternion, so we need to use the quaternion type and add its struct. Also, I forgot to comment the look class. Since the player class itself has a rotation field, we don't need to link to any other class. To get the rotation value toward the enemy, we use the look rotation function, which is a helper in the quaternion struct. There are two look rotation functions. One takes only the direction, and the other takes both direction and upward. We use the one that takes only the direction. This function is static, so it doesn't need an instance. You can also add your own look rotation function if you don't want to use the game's, like we did for distance and normalize. Now just add the offset for the look rotation method, and you're done. Anyway, Dude Theft Wars uses pitch and yaw, so I'll just restore our old code. Now just build the project. While it's building, we'll inject the mod menu code into the game. By the way, I'm using a bypassed protection APK. If you want to test the aimbot in this game, I'll provide the link to this bypassed APK on my website. I'm fast forwarding this part because I already showed how to add the mod menu to the game in the mod menu tutorial. It looks like we got some errors in the project. Oh, we forgot to remove the look rotation line. Let's remove it and build again. Now, add the menu files into the game. Now, install the game and open it. Let's test the aimbot. As you can see, it's working, but this is just a basic aimbot. It still aims at enemies behind objects and doesn't aim at the head. If you want the advanced aimbot source, message me on Telegram at AADILOP. It includes features like line of sight checks, so it won't aim at enemies behind objects, heavenly aiming, filter options, like aiming only when holding a weapon or when the enemy is within a set distance. Every line of code is explained clearly. More features may be added in the future. I'll provide the links for everything like the original APK, the source code, and the aimbot source used in this video on my website. You can download them easily. The website link will be in the description and the pinned comment. That's all for today's video. If you don't understand anything, feel free to comment on this video. Always moving on, feel I don't belong. Tell my thoughts to move along, push myself to be the best. Die with no regrets, live with every breath. See my